Thank you. Thank you. Grant peace, O Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For you are the resurrection, the life, and the repose of the path, the sons of God, Christ, the firstborn asleep, O Christ, our God. And to your strive glory, together the beginningless Father, and your holy good and laughing spirit, now and always, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Εχείρε σου, επίσαν με και πλάσαν με, συνέτησον με και μαθήσω με τα σέντολα σου, ελέησον με Κύριε.
So I shall lack of asking in that you abandoned, I have not forgotten your rules of life. Be merciful to me, O Lord.
Σώσι μη εγώ σώσον με, ότι τα δικαιώματα σου εξεζήτησα, ελέησον με Κύριε.
From all your instructions, Lord, have I never strayed, for you have given me the law. Be merciful to me, O Lord.
Έκλεινα την καρδία μου, του ποιήσε τα δικαιώματα σου εις τον αιώνα διανταμείψην, ελέησον με Κύριε.
I've inclined my heart to ways to follow your rules of life as my true reward. Be merciful to me, O Lord.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιώ και Υιώ Πνεύματι.
Act the time is upon us, for they have transgressed your law. Be merciful to me, O Lord.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιώ και Υιώ Πνεύματι.
Και νυν και εἰ και εξ ουρανὸν εἰς τὸν αἰώνα μην. Ελέησον με Κύριε, Κύριε.
Και ελέησον με Αλληλούια. Επίβλεψον επ' εμέ. Και ελέησον με. Κατά το κρίμα των αγαπώντων το όνομα σου, Αλληλούια.
Small and obscure though I am, and after the despised rules of life I have not forgotten, Αλληλούια.
Τις φωνής μου άκουσαν, Κύριε, κατά το έλεος σου, κατά το κρίμα σου ζήσον με, Αλληλούια.
Rulers unjustly persecuted me, but my heart has always stood in awe of your words. Αλληλούια.
Ζήσετε η ψυχή μου και ενέσισε, και τα κρίματα σου βοηθήσει μη, επλανήθην ως πρόβατον απολωλός, ζήτησον των δούλων σου, ότι τα σέντολά σου ου και πέλαθω μην.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, διδαξών με τα δικαιώματά σου, τον Αγίον ο χορός ευρε πηγήν της ζωής, και θύραν παραδείσου, ευρωκαγώ την οδόν διά της μετανοίας, το απολωλός πρόβατον εγώ ημί, ανακάλεσε με, σωτήρ και σώσον με.
Ευλόγητος η Κύριε, διδαξών με τα δικαιώματά σου, ο πάλε με, εκμειών των πλάσας με, και εικόνη σου θεία τιμήσας, παραβάσει εντολής δε πάλι με επιστρέψας, εις γην εξισελήφθην, εις το καθομοίο συνεπανάγαγε, το αρχαίο καλός αναμορφώσαστε.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, διδαξών με τα δικαιώματά σου, I count in mind of your ineffable glory, even though the marks of sin are on me. Take pity, Lord, on your own creation, and cleanse me in your compassion, and my chaste amen do you grant to me, making me again a citizen of paradise.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, διδαξών με τα δικαιώματά σου, ανάπαυσον, και κατάταξον αυτόν εν παραδείσο, όπου χωρεί των Αγίων Κύριε και οι δίκαιοι εκλάμψου συνοσφωστήρες των και κοιμημένων δούλων σου ανάπαυσον, παρορών αυτού πάντα τα εγκλήματα.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, the tri-brilliance of the Godhead singleness, let us praise reverently chanting. Holy are you, the beginningless Father, the beginningless Son, and the Holy Spirit. Shine upon us who in faith worship you, and deliver us from the eternal fire.
Και νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων, αμήν. Χαίρεσε μνή, η Θεός αρχιτεκούσα εις πάντων σωτηρίαν. Διείς γένος των ανθρώπων εύρατο την σωτηρίαν. Δια σου ευρημέν παράδεισον, Θεοτό και αγνή ευλογημένη.
Αλληλούια, 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 δόξα σοι ο Θεός.
Αλληλούια, 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 δόξα σοι ο Θεός.
Αλληλούια, 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 glory to you, God.
Μετά
departed, and for our souls his great mercy.
πάντος φοβερότατον, πάντα ματαιότιστα ανθρώπινα, όσα όχι υπάρχει μετά θάνατον. Ου παραμένει ο πλούτος, ου συνοδεύει δόξα, επελθόν γαροθάνατος, ταύτα πάντα εξυφάνιστε. Διο Χριστό το αθανάτο βασίλη, βοήσομεν τον μεταστάντα εξημών ανάπαυσον, εν θα πάντων εστί εφρενωμένον η κατοικία.
Indeed, how awesome is the mystery of our death, how the soul is forcibly separated from its harmonious union of the body, and of the coexistence's natural bond is broken by divine will. Therefore, we implore you, give rest to the parted one in the dwelling of the righteous, O giver of life and lover of mankind.
Που έστεινε του κόσμου προσπάθεια, που έστεινε ή των προσκαίρων φαντασία, που έστεινε ο Χρυσός και ο Άργυρος, που έστεινε τον ηκετών η πλημμύρα και ο θόρυβος. Πάντα κόνης, πάντα τέφρα, πάντα σκία, αλλά δεύτε βοήσομεν το αθανάτο βασιλεί, Κύριε, των αιωνίων σου αγαθών αξίωσον, των μεταστάντα εξημών αναπάβων αυτών, εν τη αγύρω μακαριότητη.
I brought to mind the prophet who cried, I am earth and dust, and again I looked in the graves and beheld the naked bones and said, to whom could these belong, king or soldier, rich or poor, righteous or sinner? But give rest to your departed servant, O Lord, among the just, as the gracious and the loving God.
Αρχή μη και υπόστασης, το πλαστούργο σου γεγονε πρόσταγμα. Βουληθείς γάρεξα ώρα του τε και ώρα της μεζών συμπήξε φύσεως. Γήθε μου το σώμα διέπλασας, δε δοκάς δε μη ψυχήν. Τη Θεία σου και ζώπιο εμπνεύσει, διό Χριστέ των δούλων σου, εν χώρα ζώντων, εν σκηνές δικαίων ανάπαυσον.
Ανάπαυσον σωτηρήμων ζωζώτα, ον μετέστησας αδελφών ημών, εκ των προσκαίρων κράζοντα δόξα σύρι.
Κατ' εικόνα συν και ομοίωσιν, πλαστουργήσας καταρχάς των ανθρώπων. Εν παραδείσο τέθηκας καταρχήν σου των κτισμάτων. Θόνο δε διαβόλου απατηθείς, της βρόσεως μετέσχε των εντολών σου παραβάτης γεγονός. Δύο πάλιν εις γυναίξης ελήφθη, κατεδίκα σας επιστρέφει, Κύριε, και ετήστε την ανάπαυση.
Γινώ και οδύρωμαι όταν εννοήσω τον θάνατο και είδω εν της τάφης κειμένη την κατοικώνα Θεού, πλαστήσαν ημίν ωραιότητα, άμορφον άδοξον μη έχουσαν είδους. Ο του θαύματος τι το περί μας τούτο γέγονε μυστηρίων, πως παρεδόθη μεν τη φθορά και συνεδεύθη μεν το θανάτο. όντως Θεοπροστάξιος γεγραπτέ, του παρέχοντος της μεταστάσει την ανάπαυση.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Άγιο Πνεύματι, ο θάνατος σου, Κύριε, Αθανασίας γέγονε πρόξενος, ημί γαρενήματι κατετέθης, ουκάν ο παράδεισος συνέοκτο, διό των μεταστάντα ανάπαυσον ως φιλάνθρωπος.
Αγνή Παρθένε του Λόγου πύλη, του Θεού ημών μύτη, ηκέτευε ελεήθηνε την ψυχήν αυτού. Remember us, Lord, in your kingdom. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they revile and persecute you, and so counsel evil against you falsely for my sake. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven.
Εν τη βασιλεία σου μνηστητή ημών, Κύριε, μακάρι πτωχή το πνεύματι, ότι αυτόν εστίν η βασιλεία των ουρανών. Μακάρι πενθούντες, ότι αυτοί παρακληθήσονται. Μακάρι πραείς, ότι αυτοί κληρονομήσουσι την γη. Μακάρι πεινώντες και διψώντες την δικαιοσύνη, ότι αυτοί χορταστήσονται. Μακάρι ελεήμονες, ότι αυτοί ελεήθησονται. Ληστήν του παραδείσου, Χριστέ πολίτη, επί σταυρούσι βοήσαντα, το μνηστητή μου προαφυργάσω, αυτού της μετανοίας, αξίωσον καμέ των ανάξιων.
Μακάρι καθαρίσκαζε ότι αυτοί των Θεών ούτσονται και ίσο κυριεύον και του θανάτου δέσαυλες Αγίων ανάπαυσον ον προσελάβου εκ των προσκέρων ον δαμνηστητή μου όταν έφυγεν τη βασιλεία σου.
Μακάρι ειρηνοποιεί ότι αυτοί Θεού πληθύσονται, ο των ψυχών δεσπότων και των σωμάτων, που εμπιχειρεί πνοήμων των πληγωμένων παραμυθία, ανάπαυσον ελχώρα δικαίων, ον μετέστησας δούλων σου.
Μακάρι δεδομένη εκ την δικαιοσύνη, ότι αυτόν εστίν η βασιλεία των ουρανών. Χριστός σε αναπαύσει εν χώρα ζώντων, και φύλλας παραδείσου ανοίξησι, και βασιλείες δείξε πολίτη, και άφησιν στη ζωή ονήμαρτες εν βιοφυλό Χριστέ.
Μακάρι έστε όταν ον ειδήσωσιν ημάς και διώξωσι και ύπωσι παν πονηρό ρήμα καθημών ψευδόμενη ένε και νε μου εξέλθομεν και είδομεν εν της τάφης ότι γυμνά ως θέα ο άνθρωπος σκολίκον βρώμα και δυσοδεία και γνώμεν της ο πλούτος το καλός ισχύς και η ευπρέπεια.
Χέφελιας του μισθός ημών πολλής εν της ουρανής, ακούσομεν τι κράζει ο παντοκράτων, που εξητούντες θεάσασε την φοβεράν ημέραν Κυρίου, αυτή γαρέστη σκότος, κήρυγα δοκιμάσει τα σύμπαντα.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Άγιο Πνεύματι,
ανάρχω και γεννήσιτε και πρόζω, Πατέρα προσκυνώ τον γεννήσαντα, Υιόν δοξάζω τον γεννηθέντα, Υμνώτος είναι κλάβων, Πατρίτε και Υιό Πνεύμα Άγιον.
Και νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων αμήν, πως εκ μαζών σου γαλαβρείς Παρθένε, πως στρέφεις τον τροφέα της κτήσεως, ως ίδενο πήγας ασίδων εκ πέτρας, τας φλέβας των υδάτων, διψώντη το λαό καθώς γεγράπτε.
Blessed always be the road that you travel on today, because for you has been prepared a place of eternal rest.
Makaria Iogos, Θεσσαλονικής πρώτης επιστολής Παύλου το ανάγνωσμα.
Πρόσχομαι.
Αδελφοί, ουν θέλω ημάς αγνοήν περί των πεκεκειμένων, ή να μη λυπήστε καθώς οι λυποί, ή μη έχοντες ελπίδα, ή γαρ πιστεύομεν ότι Ιησούς απέθανε και ανέστη, ούτω και ο Θεός τους κοιμηθέντας, δια του Ιησού άξις είναι αυτό. Τούτο γαρ ημίν λέγομεν εν λόγω Κυρίου, ότι εμείς οι ζώντες, οι περιλυπόμενοι, εις την παρουσίαν του Κυρίου, που μη φτάσομεν τους κοιμηθέντας, ότι αυτός ο Κύριος εν κελεύσματι, εν φωνή Αρχαγγέλου και εν σάλπιγγι Θεού, καταβίσεται απ' ουρανού, και οι νεκροί εν Χριστώ αναστήσονται πρώτον, έπειτα εμείς οι ζώντες, οι περιλυπόμενοι, άμα συναυτής αρπαγισόμεθα εν νεφέλες, εις απάντηση του Κυρίου εις αέρα και ούτω πάντοτε συν Κυρίω εσώμεθα. The reading is from the first epistle of Paul to Thessalonians.
Wisdom, let us attain.
Brethren, I do not want you to be ignorant about those who have fallen asleep, so that you will not grieve like those who have no hope. Because if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, so must we believe that God will bring with Jesus all those who have died believing in him. For this is the Lord's teaching we tell you. We the living who survive until the coming of the Lord will in no way meet him ahead of those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will come down from heaven with the shout of command, the archangel's voice, and the trumpet of God. And those who have died believing in Christ will rise first. Then we, who are still alive and remain on earth, will be caught up with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air and remain with him forever.
Peace be unto you, the redeemed.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Wisdom, stand and attend, let us hear the gospel, peace be unto you.
And with your spirit.
The reading is taken from the Gospel according to St. John. Let us attend.
Glory to you, O Lord, glory to you.
The Lord said to the Jews who came to him, I tell you the truth. Whoever hears my words and believes in him who sent me as eternal life. You will not be judged, but has already passed from death to life. I tell you the truth, the time is coming, the time has already come, when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear it will live, even as the Father is himself the source of life. In the same way he has made his Son to be the source of life, and has given the Son the right to judge, because he is the Son of Man. Not be surprised at this, for the time is coming when all the dead in the grave will hear his voice, and will come forth those who have done good deeds to the resurrection of life, and those who have done evil deeds to the resurrection of judgment. I can do nothing on my own authority, as I hear I judge, and my judgment is just, because I do not seek my own will, but the will of the Father who sent me.
Glory to you, O Lord, glory to you.
Ελέησον ημάς ο Θεός κατ' του μεγαλειώσου δρόμεν τάψου επάξουν και ελέησον.
Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον.
Can you pray for the repose of the soul of the servant of God, Christopher, who is fallen asleep, and for the forgiveness of all his errors, both voluntary and involuntary.
Glory to you, Lord, glory to you.
Lord, have mercy. That the Lord God will place his soul the righteous rest, and will grant him the mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, and the forgiveness of all his sins. There is also Christ, our King, immortal King and God.
Grant this, O Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O God, of spirit and of all flesh, who has trampled down death, crush the power of the devil, and grant the life to all. To yourself, O Lord, give rest to the soul departed servant of God, Christopher, who has fallen asleep in a place of light, a place of green pasture, a place of repose, where there is no grief, sorrow, or mourning. Forgive every sin which has committed in word or deed or thought, for you are good God who loves mankind. For there is no one who lives and does not sin, only you without sin, your righteousness and everlasting righteousness, and your word is truth. Amen.
Κύριε ελέησον.
Ησύ Ανάσταση, ζωή και μακαρία ανάπησης του προκειμένου γλώσσου, Χριστόφα Χριστέ Θεός ημών, και εσύ δόξα αναπέμπωμεν, συνδανός του Πατρίου και του Πνεύματος και Θεού, και ζωπιός του Πνεύματος την ίν και αΐ, και εσώνας τον αιώνο.
Αμήν.
Πρόητα παρά, πρόητα με Christ, our true God, who rose from the dead, and has dominion over the living and the dead, as immortal kings and descendants of his most pure and undefiled mother, of the Holy Ghost, all praise the apostles, of our holy and God-bearing fathers, of the holy and glorious forefathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, of his holy and righteous friend Lazarus, who was 4 days in a tomb, and of all the saints, the saint at one place of the righteous, the soul of his servant Christopher, the departed from among us, grant the rest in the bosom of Abraham, and numbered among the righteous, may also have mercy upon us and save us, who is a good God who loves mankind. Amen. Be eternal, ever blessed in the middle, brother in Christ. The only answer in the image of Christ that came is that I am on. Together always, as one body, as one family, in a place, in a space, a sanctified and a holy temple, where we chant and offer whatever we can from our heart, and we do so in trusting one thing, and that is the love and the mercy of a God of love, of power, of omnipotence, who is always present everywhere and fillest all things. The words we say in the funeral services and the things that we can offer, especially so in days that we live in, are for us not only something that should give us an understanding of power and strength in trusting and putting our hope, as it says, we mustn't grieve like those who are ignorant about the truth. And therefore, we entrust ourselves to something that is far bigger, far more perfect, far more graceful, and we try and trust ourselves to a beloved, to a God who is totally abundant and full of mercy and full of grace, and who definitely tells us not once but a million times over in the funeral service how he has trampled down death by death, how he has conquered death, has risen from the dead, and that the dead, the death has no more dominion over him, and that he is the one who has the dominion over the living and the dead. These are words that we often say, but we often cannot comprehend, like most things in the world that man participates in and has an attachment to. We read words, we read theories, we read philosophies and ideas, but unless man experiences something, he does not understand it fully, cannot comprehend it, and it is in this that the Church and the Orthodox Church should give us the greatest hope and the greatest courage, because we live and experience every single service of and we reenact the participation of a crucified and a living God who resurrected from the dead. And this must give us a lot of hope and courage, because our friend Christopher always allowed God's space in his heart to work, always came to church, always tried, and it is in this that we too then should find consolation. Most of the funeral service beseeches for God's mercy because we have obeyed his commandments, or because we have tried, and even though we are small and obscure, even though our soul has not always done what it had, should have done, and has wandered, it says, like a sheep who has lost the trodden path, even though we very often are full of scars from sins and imperfections, what should allow us the greatest consolation, the greatest comfort, especially so in days of today, are the fact that we are here very, very briefly, and that ultimately our purpose, our destination, and our ending point is always to unite within the embrace of God, in which everything then is concluded, everything is funneled, and receives its light, as it leads, it receives its strength, and it is in this that we take hope. Let us remember these words, so that when we grieve, we do not grieve, as it says, like those who have not hope. We do not say only Zoe Semas, life to us, and if we mean life to us, we do not mean it over here only. We mean it eternally, and eternally it means that we must unite ourselves to the soul on the other side through prayers, through the church, through the love and charities and things that we can give on behalf of the soul, because this is truly words from the church that unite us and allow us and give that soul a union with us, a participation where we do definitely feel our offering, our love, and the soul receives these on the other side. A couple of years. And as much as we might sometimes think it's a lot, 10 or 20 years before man blinks, he wakes up and everything seems like a dream that has dissolved away and become something that was just some part of his life that was obliterated into something that only became meaningful when he lives in the present and in the fullness of God. And the conclusion of everything he does, the charities, the love, the mercy, the forgiveness, for people that hurt us, for harm us, for people that
we have heard of old, or that allow us always an experience. It is always something that God has offered and provided for us, including the virus and everything that is going on around us today. These are spiritual states, and as much and as difficult as they are, when we immerse ourselves in Christ and in His light, we use these challenges, we use them a little bit more on our knees, spend a bit more time, and realize the benefit, in inverted commas, of the pain that we sometimes go through. Because eternally, if we remember, that's what counts, and whatever has come across our way that we have looked at in the right way, we will have allowed God to sanctify us through this, whether it was a good thing, a bad thing, a challenging thing. And I say bad thing, nothing can be bad if we've got the correct disposition and intent in our heart. Let us remind ourselves of these words, and always remember that it's about kalop aradiso, getting closer to God like that, uniting ourselves in that way. And in doing that, we do receive always the message of resurrection in our heart, the message of hope, the message of comfort and consolation. And in this then, we also make our lives a living offering and an experience, and not something that remains as a theory, as a book, as an ideology or philosophy. Christ is the living God, our life is a living experience. We are living and celebrating in the presence of God, and that is what we have right here and now. Let us remind ourselves of these things, so that the resurrection of Christ becomes living, and we do not celebrate a resurrected Christ with a fear of death, but more so, a resurrected Christ with understanding that death unites us, and even though it is painful at times, we are able to then say, I expect the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come, and thy kingdom come, in a way that definitely is lived and experienced by what love, what mercy, what forgiveness, and whatever it is that radiates to everybody around us, because the experience becomes something that we look forward to, we anticipate, but are part of right here and now. God rest your soul and give you strength to remember a few of these things. Remember even your prayers, remember to do the Isaiah, the 3rd, the 9th, the 40th day, to do as much prayer as you can and the offerings that we can, because these things will give you a lot of consolation and a lot of help. Jesus says, we also need to keep an eye upon those who seem to be in this, but yes, but you may, I don't know if you pass, I don't know if you pass, and I don't know if you και παρησία, να μπορείτε στο Θεό και εσείς του Θεού, όπως είναι και βρίσκεται και εκείνος στο Ραβά, να μπορείτε να εμπιστεύεστε τη χάρη και την αγάπη του Θεού και την Ανάσταση, τα λόγια του Θεού που είναι η αλήθεια. Ζωή σε εσάς και τον Αγία μαζί σας, δεν αγγίσει κανένας.
Γνωρίζει τον Άκη προσωπικά και ξέρετε πολύ καλά τι ήταν το Άκης. Είχετε κάτι, είχετε καλά του, αλλά είχετε καλά του. Πάντα ο Άκης ήταν πρόθυμος να μας βοηθήσει όλους, εν όλους, εν όλους. Έχω πολλές, πολλές καλές αναμνήσεις που μπορώ να σας πω για τον Άκη. Αν αρχίσω να σας τα λέω, δεν θα τελειώσω. Θα σας πω μόνο μια ανάμνηση. Πριν ένα μήνα ήρθε στο Δέλτα και μου έλεγε και μου λέει «Χριστό, τι είδε Άκη, να ξανάρθω». Λέγα γύρω του, «Πότε μου να ξανάρθεις, να ξανάρθω να μην πω». Όταν έλεγε «Θεέ Παύλο, του γύπου του Παύλου, ο Παύλος ήταν με σεξι, να πω του Ράκη, μην με περιμένεις σε μένα, ενάρτησε για τα ενέργεια του Παύλου ή ενάρτησε για τον Τζουλά». Λέει μου, «Όχι, όχι, 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 όχι». Εγώ ήμουν αρκετή ο Παύλος, εντάξει να μου λέει, τον Τζουλά είναι στις 3, ο Παύλος είναι στις 6, αλλά στις 5. Όχι, δεν έρθει πιο κοντά να μου, εκείνεται. Καλά να του λέει, που να έρθεις τηλεφώνα μου, να ξέρω και όταν πρώτα αυτό γίνει να βάζω το κάτω κολλά του και βαρύγασε. Ενώ εγώ και γελώ. Και γελώ. Εγώ πήγαινε μέσα στα ρουλά όλα του Ιάκη. Με φας ρε, μόλις πάντα σου τηλεφωνεί. Μπορεί και έκαι μου τηλεφωνεί λάθο. Όχι να σου τηλεφωνεί όλα. Εξεκινώμε με τον Δέμπα να έρθουμε στο Τζοχάνεσμε ή να πάμε στο Μέρκο. Θα μας τηλεφώνανε 100 φορές. Πού είσαστε, τι κάνετε, είστε καλά, είστε καλά. Για πάντα, πάντα ο Άγγις ήταν για μένα να βοηθήσει τους πάντες. Τους πάντες και τους πάντες. Έτσι θα τον ξεχάσω ποτέ μου. Ήταν ένας κύριος. Πέρασαμε τα δύσκολα μας, αλλά τώρα τελευταίο ο Άγγις δεν ξέρω. Πάντα ήταν ένας κύριος. Πώς είστε εδώ, πρέπει ο Άγγις να σας έστειλε κάθε μέρα στο Facebook να σας πει κάτι, Κάθε μέρα. Σε το λέω ρε Άγγι. Τι όταν τα λεφτά μου τρώει στο WhatsApp να το πει, εγώ μετά πέρα να βγει να βάλω στην τράπεζα. Να λέει, όχι, είναι εντάξει, να λέει, ωραία και να λέει, ωραία και. Έκανε στο δέρμα, να το γουράζουν τους φαγητά του, λέει, δυο τους ένα, δυο τους άλλους, όχι, όχι, να βάλω στην τράπεζα. Εντάξει, να λέει, πλέον θα τα πω. Τι γελούσα. Ο Άγγις, έφυγε μας έτσι γρήγορα και απρόσθετα, δεν ξέρω πώς έφυγε. Δεν ήθελε να το πει κανεί νου ότι ήταν άρρωστος. Δεν ήθελε κανένα να το κάνει να ανησυχήσει. Ενώ πιστεύω ότι όταν μας τηλεφώνησε και μας πει άρρωστος, ήταν άρρωστος να δούμε τι κάνουμε και να κάνουμε και εμείς την αρρώστια που δεν ήταν άρρωστος. Τα πάντα ο Άγγις σκέφτεται τον άλλο και μετά τον εαυτό του. Πολλά πράγματα. Αλλά τώρα εκεί πάνω που είναι, μας περιμένει όλους μας. Ένας, όλοι μας θα πάμε εκεί. Ο Άγγις, όπως βλέπω, η καλή ανθρώπινη βάση. Όσους χρειάζεται ο Θεός και τους θέλει δίπλα του, τους παίρνει. Εμάς δεν μας χρειάζεται, γι' αυτό και είμαστε εδώ. Τι να κάνουμε, δεν πειράζει. Αιωνία ζωή είναι η μοιράκη μου και πέρα αλλό του πατέρα σου, την μητέρα σου, δεν τους εγνώρισα. Αιωνία έχει.
Tell everyone a little bit about my brother Aki, who left us on Sunday. I call him my brother because he was like the brother I never had. A few hours had passed after hearing the traumatizing news about Aki. Renee and I were still both in days of shock. She walked out of the kitchen and came to me in the lounge and pointed out something we had never noticed before. When she opened the pantry door in the kitchen, there on the shelf was the powdered dessert Aki had gifted us on one of his visits. And in the fridge was the jam from Greece which he had gifted us on another visit. In the cupboard holding the cups were his gift to Renee for her birthday, cups with little images of cats on them. On the windowsill, a 5-litre tank of olive oil from Greece. By Iconis, the super dry watch he had given me for my birthday. None of these gifts were cheap. The tank of oil, I'm sure, was in the region of 500-600 rand. The super dry watch was, I'm sure, in the thousands. Whenever he visited me at work, he never came empty-handed, always bringing something for me and Renee and my staff: biscuits, fruit, chocolates, nuts, sweets. The list is endless. I mean, how much generosity from someone who was earning a basic income. My staff loved Aki. As Sunday and Monday passed, and people began phoning to show their respect, I learned something else about Aki. We have a little WhatsApp prayer group going among friends and family. Every morning we receive a message. as we read from Aki, something inspirational and uplifting. And then Aki would send me my own personal uplifting message, the last one on Sunday read, "Good morning, may God's blessings shine on you today." Well, it wasn't just me receiving these daily messages. Almost every person that I called and others that I've now learnt of received a daily quote of love, joy and inspiration. This is a long list of people who received like a personal bundle of joy. Every day, how proud and amazed I was of him. Somehow, in all the sadness and misery of losing him, glimmers of his actions were keeping me pricked up, little bursts of inspiration. And not all the messages were the same. It must have taken so much time to send these individual messages to so many people every day. But Aki wanted this. He wanted to bring happiness and smiles to people's faces. When I went to his home after he passed on to collect a few things necessary for our gathering here today, I noticed in his wardrobe a pile of programs just like the ones we received today, of people's funerals that he had attended to pay his last respects. It was a pile about this high. I have been very close with Aki, Arthur and Eva since my teens. They lost their parents at an early age. Not easy to deal with losing both parents at once from an early age. Aki struggled with it for a few years after. Conflict resulted in living by choice away from his siblings. Around 10 years ago, when I returned from my stay in Cyprus, I caught up with him on the West Rand of Joburg. Still angry with life, although he never showed it. Fast forward 6 or 7 years, and a new Aki had emerged. Always well-dressed, smiling, and beaming with happiness, he had established relationships with so many people in his community. He was proud of his work and how devoted he was to all of his customers he had. He was then a rep and refused to call by phone to take orders from his customers. He had to go in person to see them every time. I have now learned of how he had helped people in the community, some in a small way, others in a bigger way. People loved having him visit at work or at home for lunch or dinner. Several times when we asked him to come over for lunch or dinner, his reply was, "Sorry, Rekisto, but I've been invited to so and so." I'm quite simply amazed at how he achieved a total turnaround. He was now in control. He had finally found himself and loved the person he had become. I'm truly deeply inspired by my cousin, brother, and great friend, Aki. He gave gifts, he gave joy, he gave his time and effort, he gave respect, he gave his love. And in return, received more and more from people and from God. He had learned that the more you give, the closer you get to God. As a close friend of mine put it, he may have not been rich in currency, but he was a millionaire in what counts the most. I'm overwhelmingly inspired, and I truly hope that you all will be too. Thank you, Aki. I love you. Sorry. I also have a word here from his cousins in Cyprus. Αγαπημένα μας ξαδέρφια, με πόνο ψυχής πληροφορήθηκαμε με τον πρόωρο χαμό του Άκη μας. Κρατάμε το αυστηρότερο χαμόγελο του, την καλή του καρδιά και το καλόσυνατο χαρακτήρα του. Καλό παράδεισο στη γειτονιά των Αγγέλων. Εκεί τον περιμένουμε οι λατρεμένοι του γονείς. Αιωνία του η μνήμη, ελαφρύ το χώμα που θα τον σκεπάσει. So that once again, that's from the cousins in Cyprus. The next message is from Andrea from Durban, that's Eva and Christo's son.
brings how much love, care, and happiness you brought to everyone's soul that you crossed paths with. I am extremely grateful to have been gifted such an amazing uncle in my life, who has taught me to always smile, to always be happy, and to always be appreciative for what you have been given in life. I am always excited to see you, I am always excited to spend time with you, and our conversations always involve lots of laughs, soccer stories, which I know you and me will love and cherish forever and ever. There is never a dull moment with you, and you have this gift of always making your presence known in the room, no matter where you are in life. I know you are looking down on all of us now, up in heaven, with Papu and Yaya, and I promise you that I'm going to make you the most proud uncle this unforgiving world has ever seen. Every sunrise and sunset has your name and energy written all over it, and I know we have all gained a guardian angel that's going to protect us wherever we go. I want you to know that I'm going to do everything in my power to look after and be there for my beautiful mother. It's never goodbye, Joaquin, and it's until next time. I love you, Theo, and you are forever in my heart and thoughts.
As is customary in the Orthodox Church, we do all come to friends to bid our last farewell. Whoever wants to is welcome to come to the front. Thank you. Yes, it's us, it's just a mess.
Oh, don't let it.
Thank you. Thank you. guys, you okay? What are you doing?
Someone's gonna.
Thank you.
Τότε πάτε λίγο άμμο να βάλω. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.